Today, friends, let us learn unit number 3, that is applications or uses, applications of differentiation. We have learned differentiation. Now, we will take up the application, that is where differentiation is used. Now it can be used to find write the equation to tangent or normal to a curve at any given point on it. It can also be used to measure rate of change of displacement velocity radius area volume etc. And it can be used to find maxima and minima of a function. So for these purposes we can use them. We get problems on using this. When we do those problems, we will understand what it is. Now, first, let us take one by one these things. We will solve some problems. We will understand while solving those problems how to use this. In this also you get about 14 marks. We will take up some problems. See, November-December 2017 paper, November-December 2017 paper, section A, 7th problem, for 3 marks. Find the equation to the tangent to the curve. Find the equation to the tangent to the curve y is equal to x square plus 1 at 1, 2. Now I'll just draw a rough figure. Let us say y is equal to x square plus 1 is a curve like this. This is a curve. This is the locus of a point which is according to this. Now that is this thing. Now here on this curve there is a point. This point let us say is 1, 2. Now if you draw a tangent to this curve, at this point, this tangent, you know, is a straight line. Now, we are asked to write the equation to this tangent straight line. Now, if I draw a line through this point perpendicular to the tangent, this is called as normal. This straight line is called as normal and this is called as the tangent. They can ask us to write the equation either to the tangent or to the normal. Now what we have to do here is, first we have to find out the derivative of this. That is, we have to find out dy by dx. Dy by dx at that point, I'll call that point as x1, y1. The given point 1, 2 is x1, y1. This will give me the slope of the tangent. The slope of the tangent. Now, the x, dy by dx of this will be 2x plus 0. X square, differentiation of x square is 2x, 1 is a constant, so it is 0 at the point 1, 2. Now, here no y is there, only x is there, so 2 into 1, that is equal to 2. So this is slope of tangent. If they had asked to find the write the equation to the normal, then slope of normal, if it was asked, slope of normal is, that is slope of this line, will be minus 1 by dy by dx at x1, y1. This will give you the slope. Here we don't need to do this because we have been asked to find the equation to the tangent. So this is the slope of the tangent, m. This is m. Now we know the slope of this line, and we know that this line is passing through 1, 2. So its equation to the tangent, can be written in slope point form. That is, because we know the slope, we know one point through which that line is, straight line is passing. So slope point form is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. M is 2, x1 y1 is 1, 2. So y minus 2, y1 is 2, is equal to m is 2 into x minus x1 is 1. So y minus 2 is equal to 2x minus 2. This minus 2 gets cancelled. So 2x minus y is equal to 0. This is the equation to the tangent. That is the equation to the tangent. This problem carries 3 marks. Next, April, May 2017, section A, problem number 7. If the slope of the tangent to the curve, one plus x cube divided by 3 is 4, find the value of x. That is, what is x? Here we have they have given the slope of the tangent, and they are asking us to find what is the value of x. So what we have to do is, d by dx of, slope means d by dx of this 1 plus x cube by 3 is equal to 4. What is x? This is the question. find x. Now this can be written as m slope is equal to d by dx of this, that is equal to 4. Now here what I do is take out this 1 by 3 outside, it's a constant. So d by what remains here is 1 plus x cube, d by dx of 1 is 0, 0 plus 3x, 3x square is equal to 4. This is 3x square, differentiation of this is 3x square. So 1 by 3 into 3x square is equal to 4. So this 3 gets cancelled, x square is equal to 4. So x is square root of 4, that is plus or minus 2. This is the answer. This carries again three marks. Next, November-December 2016, November-December 2016, problem number 7, 3 marks, section A, problem number 3, find the equation to the tangent to the curve y is equal to 3x square plus 4x at 1, 2. Here, this is very similar to the first problem that we did. The first problem we did. So, they have given an equation which represents a curve. This equation represents a curve. We have to find the equation to the tangent drawn to this curve at this particular point on the curve. So now slope m is equal to dy by dx, slope of tangent, that is dy by dx, that is d by dx of 3x square plus 4x. So the differentiation of this is 6x plus 4 at this point. So value of at x1, y1. So now at 1, 2, the value of this at 1, 2. Here x is 1. So 6 into 1 plus 4, that will give me 10. This is the slope. 10 is the slope of the tangent. And it is passing through this. Again, this is the equation. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y will be y only. Y1 is 2. Y minus 2 is equal to m is 10 into x minus x1 is 1. So y minus 2 is equal to 10x minus 10. Now, this x is positive, so 10x minus y minus 10 plus 2 is equal to 0. So, 10x minus y minus 8 is equal to 0. This is the equation to the tangent to this curve at that point. So, similar problems are there on writing equation to tangent. Now we'll take other type, displacement, velocity. We'll take this problem. November, December 2017. November-December 2017, problem number 8. The displacement of a particle s meters moving along a straight line is s is equal to 4t cube minus 2t square plus t find the velocity when t is 2 seconds. This is the problem. What is the velocity if the equation to motion, equation of displacement is this? What is the velocity of the body at the end of 2 seconds is what we have to find out. So we know in physics we have been taught the definition of velocity is defined as rate of change of displacement. So here velocity at any given time will be equal to rate of change of displacement, means derivative of this equation at t. Here at t value is 2 seconds. So d by dt of 4t cube minus 2t square plus t when t is equal to 2. So the differentiation of this is 12t square, 4 3s are 12, t square minus 2 2s are 4, t square becomes t, plus the differentiation of t is 1 when t is 2. So now we will substitute t as 2 seconds. 12 into 2 square minus 4 into 2 plus 1. 2 square is 4, 4 into 12 is 48 minus 12 plus 1. 48 minus 12 is 36, 36 plus 1 is 37 meters per second. This is the velocity of the body at the end of 2 seconds. Similarly, April, May 2000, April, May 2017, problem number 8. April, May 2017, problem number 8. Now they have given the equation of motion of a particle is s is equal to t cube minus 2t square plus 4 in meters. Find the velocity when t is 2 seconds. Again the same thing. So v is equal to ds by dt. Same procedure is to be followed. So v is equal to ds by dt, that is 3t square minus 4t plus 0. Differentiation of 4 is 0. So it is 3t square minus 4t. Now put t is equal to 2. So 3 into 2 square minus 4 into 2. 2 square is 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 minus 8. So v is 4 meters per second at the end of 2 seconds. The velocity of the body is 4 meters per second. So like this we have to do these problems. Similarly, November, December 2016. Here again, question number 8. November, December 2016. Again, question number 8. Find the velocity if s is equal to 3t square plus 4t plus 6 40 plus 6, find the velocity after 2 seconds. Again, same thing we have to do. ds, v is ds by dt, that is d by dt of 3t square plus 4t plus 6. So it works out to 6t plus 4 plus, this is 0, 0. So 6t plus 4. Now t is 2, 6 into 2 plus 4, 12 plus 4. So velocity is 16 meters per second at the end of 2 seconds. This is how it is to be done.